I'll put in writing with my finger and sign with blood that I will commit to a specific time when I will leave my husband and I will make a permanent life and home with the man.
And then she stopped returning my calls.
So, quick question. Why did Anna think that this was a reasonable thing to say? Why the hell did she think that this would convince Daisy and John to let her see Derek? What? I'm gonna sign my name in blood? How does she not know that this would come off as like crazy stalker? So, I recently watched the Netflix documentary, Tell Them You Love Me, and I came away with a lot of questions. So, the way they set up this documentary, they tell you very early on that Anna went to prison, but they don't tell you what for. Then we backtrack into when she was chair of the Department of Philosophy over at Rutgers.
I also provide support to people labeled with developmental disabilities. I work with people who cannot communicate vocally to provide them with access to alternative forms of verbal expression and to literacy.
She taught there as a philosophy professor, showed a documentary about facilitated communication. This man, John, is in her class. He sees that. He wants to know if facilitated communication can help his brother with disabilities.
Sometimes he's self-abusive. We can be somewhere, and then all of a sudden, put his hand in his mouth and start banging his head and his knee. And I don't know why. Maybe he's frustrated, but he can't communicate. So what is going on in your head, Derek? Like, to me, that was the great mystery.
His brother has cerebral palsy. There are some things that made John a little suspicious, thinking maybe there's more to what's going on in his head than we are able to comprehend because he cannot speak. Sometimes it seems like he wants to join in on the conversation. Maybe he actually knows more about what's going on around him than other people realize. So he wants to know what's going on. Therefore, he asks Anna about facilitated communication, and she starts helping D-Man. No, she calls him D-Man. So with facilitated communication, he has trouble with like muscle spasms and controlling his muscles and things. And she needs to support his arms so that he can point to pictures when she asks him questions. But when it comes to typing, he really cannot pick out those letters by himself. So she has to hold his hand, hold four of his fingers down so that only his pointer finger is up so that he can point to the letters. The documentary doesn't tell you about the controversy with facilitated communication right away. At first, it's framed like, it's a miracle. We have Anna telling her side of the story in her own words, where she thinks that she's committed no crime. And again, if you go into this cold, I did not go into this cold, you do not know what crime she has committed yet. And then John and Daisy have great things to say about her at the start of the documentary, and great things to say about Derek's progress, etc.
I think as an instructor, she was great. And as a scholar, she was great as well.
She was Miss Anna. You know, she could do great things. She was gonna move mountains, and I accepted her at her word.
Until things start to take a turn. This is a family that goes to church every Sunday. He is always swaying when listening to the gospel music. It's very clear that he enjoys listening to that. But at one point, she changed the radio station and told Daisy, Derek's mom, oh, Derek doesn't want to listen to that. He likes classical music. You don't need facilitate communication to figure out what kind of music he prefers if he's dancing along to the gospel music. She had other things to say about his preferences that just didn't line up with what they knew of him. But things started to really take a turn when
he asked me to kiss him, and I did. And then he said, kiss me again, and I did.
She talks about it like it's forbidden love because, you know, she was married at the time with two children, and he is disabled and diagnosed as...
Derek visited a few psychologists. They deemed him, as the term they used, mentally retarded, nonverbal, with cerebral palsy. You know, then not knowing what the heck that meant, It just meant that Derek can't walk, Derek can't talk.
Somebody who cannot actually consent. And the fact that he needs her facilitation in order to consent, that is a little bit sketchy. Anna decided to announce, we are in love and we have a physical relationship.
And I was like, what? Yes, we made love. He's a man in every sense of the word.
So there was that. I do not know what was going through her head. Have you ever introduced a partner to your parents or to their parents? Have you ever said, we are not only dating, but we have had sex. We had sex in my office. We had sex in his bed, at your house, while you were at church. Like, what? No.
My office has enough floor space, and I brought in an exercise mat and the beach towel, and we were able to make things work.
Naturally, they are disturbed by this news.
Had this mat on the floor. And then you recall that moment or that day where I was changing Derek's diaper and I saw these abrasions on his back. Strawberries, like somebody's dragging you across the floor.
And he couldn't understand what was going on. And he called the day school asking if Derek had fell. But then when he found out that Anna basically put him on the floor on a yoga mat and then got on top of him.
I don't know how much she weighed, but she's much heavier than him. Derek is slight. He's 5'3", 5'4". And she was exerting so much force on him that his back was being dragged across this mat and it was leaving scars.
And if facilitated communication worked, he would have told her about that after the fact or during the fact, like, I am in pain.
It was John who came to her. And
yeah.
One of the biggest motivators, he said, was because he wanted to know when his brother was in pain. He wanted to know when his brother needed hospital care as opposed to just Tylenol.
I wish that they had asked Anna about that, like, did you know that you had caused him pain? Did he ever mention that? Why do you think he didn't mention that?
That woman did not give a damn about my brother.
John, Derek's older brother, who had introduced Anna to Derek, he starts talking about his suspicions with facilitated communication and how he looked into it and found out that it's like basically pseudoscience.
But Shane wanted to discover what happened if each saw a different picture.
Okay.
When Betsy saw a cup, she didn't type cup, she typed hat, what the facilitator saw.
My question then is, since facilitated communication was debunked like at least a decade, if not two, before this whole thing happened, why wasn't she at all skeptical of it?
The scientific evidence suggested that far from unlocking the minds of autistic individuals, FC tapped the unconscious thoughts of the facilitator.
I can understand now that you wouldn't want to reevaluate what you did and come to the conclusion that you committed rape, like you committed a crime that most people consider completely unforgivable. So of course she would want to dig her head in her sand and be in denial further. But why was she in denial in the first place before she ever met Derek? I'm curious about that.
I'm the most important person in his life.
One, it is rude to say I am the most important person in his life when you've only known him for 2 years. You're saying that to his mother who's taking care of him for 3 decades. That is disrespectful. But also, you yourself are a mother. The most important people in your life should be your children, and you could have stayed together with those children, had your marriage, your prestigious job, and everything, had you not thrown it away for this, and had you not become this big stalker. They were not planning on going to the police right away.
At the time, we weren't trying to pursue any kind of legal thing. We just wanted to leave us alone.
She forced their hand because John and Daisy, of course, they did not want Anna to see Derek anymore, but she wouldn't have that. She came over to their house uninvited. She left creepy voice messages like this.
He left this message, you know, I will sign my name in blood so I can be with Derek. And at that point, I was just like, oh, this is off the chain. Something's wrong here.
What were you thinking, girl? And then she tried to see Derek behind their back by going to his day school and trying to contact administration there. And so they decide, okay, this is when we have to go to the police. After she is charged with sexual assault.
When the jury read the conviction, I started saying out loud to the judge, just, you know, please let me take care of my daughter. You know,
why just your daughter? You have two kids, a son and a daughter. You had a whole husband. Threw away everything.
A friend of mine who is another, somebody else who uses facilitated communication, who knew Demann and was friends with Demann. And
somebody who uses FC told me exactly what I wanted to hear. Shocking. This ends with Anna trying to reassure herself because she heard from somebody else who also uses FC that they would rather have the relationship with you and lose it than not have that relationship at all.
So I hope that he's right.
And as I heard this, I thought, oh my God, is there going to be a sequel to this documentary? Who is this friend who uses FC? Does this friend need you to facilitate their communication? Or your mom? Or one of your friends? I need more information about who this friend is, if they are able to communicate on their own, if this is another Derek, somebody who has an intellectual disability, but once they use FC, then they're able to read like 10 pages per minute. Like, is it that situation? Who is this person?
People don't think that there was damage done. Yes, it was. And it's still going on.
I just want to say that I am fully sympathetic to Derek and his whole family. What they went through was completely awful. It was inexcusable. And Anna was completely wrong in that situation. What Daisy said next confused the hell out of me. And I just wanted to know what other people had to say about it.
I had to put him on medication. Because he masturbate.
He's a physically mature man. I know that intellectually, not as much, but I feel like when it comes to things like masturbation, that's you don't need to be intellectually on the same level as an average adult to realize that when you put your hands down your pants, that feels good. I watched other videos hoping that other people would talk about this, especially psychologists, because I want to know.
And she did that. Because if you don't ever strike that match or do whatever, how will you ever know?
Maybe the issue isn't just that he's masturbating. It's that with his intellectual disability, I don't know if he knows the difference between what you can do in public versus what you can do in private. Whereas, you know, most of us understand that masturbation is okay, just only do it in private. But I don't know if they would be able to explain that one to Derek. I don't know, I kind of found that a little bit odd if he hadn't discovered that before. So I wanted to know if any experts had weighed in on that part in particular, because I was a little bit confused.